for the past couple of months. The business has been looking up. Results have been decent whenever they have come out with numbers. And otherwise, brokerages seem to be fairly bullish. Dish TV is one. We've spoken to the company earlier on, before the World Cup started, about how it could prove to be a big bonanza for the company because of ad connections. World Cup got over, IPL has started, and I'm guessing the fever just continues. CLSA recently came out with a report stating that they believe that Dish TV is driving the digital revolution, and as early as 2014 is when, even on the bottom line, they would break even. Of course, there are other news about the Supreme Court interim order and lots to talk about. So let's get in Salil Kapoor, CEO of Dish TV, to talk about all of that and more. Salil, hi, thanks so much for joining in. This is Neeraj here. Good morning.
Hi.
Morning. Let's start with a basic question. I'm wondering if the IPL has proved to be as big a bonanza as the World Cup was, because you guys were very upbeat at the start of the World Cup about increased connections, so on and so forth. Did that indeed take place, and has it continued through the IPL season?
So World Cup was better, and I think it's very visible all across. Even the ratings are saying the same story. World Cup was much better than IPL. It was a country participation, the entire country was involved, and then we went on with our winning streak as a team, and finally we won the World Cup. So we ended up on a huge high. Our numbers grew by about 50-20% as an industry. So post World Cup, the numbers have come down to the earlier level, that is pre-World Cup levels. So IPL is now probably warming up a little. I can see the change in the last one or two days. But the initial part of the IPL was not a huge draw as far as our sales are concerned.
What's the expectation in this quarter about the kind of additions you want to make? I mean, analysts forecast the DTH users for your company should double to about 16 million in 3 years, with FY11 seeing almost 11 million additions. Are you on a quarterly basis pretty much on your run rate, or even a monthly basis on your run rate to getting to that target?
Yeah, we are pretty much on the run rate. Last quarter we did, that is the exit quarter of last fiscal, we did about 1 million subscribers, and we have an outlook that this quarter will also be almost there. So we have a plan of acquiring about 3.5 million subscribers current fiscal, which is very similar to what we acquired last fiscal. So we are maintaining our run rate as far as our plans are concerned. See, there are a lot of positives which are happening as far as the overall industry is concerned. Cricket, of course, helps us a lot. And World Cup was a huge high. IPL has not shown that high, but it's sustaining the numbers, which is pre-World Cup numbers. There is no dip after that huge high of World Cup. Then West Indies series is just across the corner, followed by England series. A lot of cricket happening. We've also gained by high definition. We launched about high definition 30 of channels. ET Now is one of them. Times Now is another. So 30 channels across various genres. That is also helping us a lot. So about 10% of our subs, which are coming from high definition side, is also adding up a huge positive. On top of that, there is a positive order from Supreme Court. On top of that, there is a digitization order, then rupee strong, which is all adding up to a very good, strong tailwind to the industry, I would say.
Just wondering, Salil, since you mentioned that, correct me if I'm wrong, but I thought that with the recent Supreme Court ruling that DTH operators would pay 42% of wholesale rate versus the 35%, I mean, a couple of people would have believed that this would mean that the content cost for DTH companies goes up, which would be a negative for companies such as yours. That's not true?
No. So let me clear it. Let me clarify it. Let's get down to the facts. The initial was at a 50% level. Then there was a thing which came up and said, let's do it at 35% level. But then it was overruled. And finally, Supreme Court has given an interim order which says 42%. Now, don't compare it with what you wanted. You always wanted 35. Compare it with what you had. So that is 50. So it's an 8% improvement from 50. So that's quite some benefit. But having said that, let me also tell you that the overall, most of our content cost is fixed. And because the content cost is fixed, the immediate effect is not visible. However, as soon as the contracts come up for negotiation, so we'll start talking not from the 50% level in our mind, but from 42% level. So it's a benefit for us. So let's look at this. It's 50 versus 42. So it's a net gain of about 8%.
Sure. Does that mean that, you know, whatever adjustment in content cost does happen will be passed on to customers? How would you adjust for that in your financials?
Not necessarily. Everything is not passed on. We are an industry which is based on a self subsidy kind of model. We are subsidizing the acquisition. The customers are getting something which is very expensive at a very low and a reasonable cost. So I don't think everything will be passed on to the subscriber in this case. Something should add up to the bottom line of the companies as well.
Hmm. Okay, Sunil, before we wind up the discussion, you know, I was looking at a few reports. One of them suggests that FY12, FY13, you would do a revenue growth of anywhere between 25% to 30%. And they also believe that FY13 would be the year where you would come very close to break even, possibly even break even. You think that would happen?
I would not like to comment on the reports which are coming up. Every analyst has his or her own view. I would just say that our performance, if you see from last few quarters and the track record that we have, we became a bit positive well before everyone expected, and we will also become cash flow positive much before everyone expects. So that's all I can say, but I don't want to comment on the exact timing. But as I said, there are a lot of positive tailwinds to the entire thing. The digitization is going to drive it big. See, today DTH is the preferred choice across not only metros but also in the smaller towns. So when the digitization wave starts and the government seems committed, FY12 and then 13 and then 14, they want to finish the metros and then move on to the million plus cities and then rest of India. So DTH is going to be the biggest gainer, I believe, because we offer various things, not only the transparency but also the VAS and the various other like services like high definition, which maybe the cable cannot. So that's the benefit. So that's a strong tailwind. On top of that, rupee is going strong, and we feel the rupee will remain strong for quite some time. And since a lot of our imports are in dollar terms, for example, the boxes, the middleware, the software, so and even the transponder cost. So everything is positive as of now.
All right, we leave it at that. Thanks very much for joining us and giving us that quick perspective about your business, CLSA, upgrading Dish TV. Buy with the target of 85 is what they are saying right now. Deepak, very quickly, come to your specific ideas and also a quick word on the DTH space, the media space really broadly, how you view that on the charts.
The media space, it's very stock specific. Dish TV, the stock also is looking reasonably hunky-dory. I mean, it's gone up 40% since this bull market began. Well-established, decent sort of uptrend. Nothing too spectacular, but look safe enough at the moment. The other media stocks, I mean, you have stocks like Reliance Media, which don't look